So you'll see here off the barn, we have this shed that's kind of been half falling down for the last 10 years. We're kind of waiting for the snow to do its job, but it hasn't completely fallen down. But we are gonna actually rip it off, and then we're gonna replace it with maybe a shed that's not as wide, but it's as wide as the building, and give us more of a pole barn thing so we can pull up. So we'll kind of change the flow around the space. So we're gonna enter from the other side of the barn now, go behind the building and be able to pull under the pole barn and then pull right through this way. So all of our delivering and loading can be done around the back of the building, avoiding the really kind of treacherous turning and allowing us to just offload and unload and load back up through the same entrance. So we'll have like a dirty entrance on one side and a clean exit on the other side to be able to maintain more of that separation. And so this will come off. There'll be a new shed on the back, which will have gravel floor initially, maybe cement floor down the road. And that way we'll be able to purchase our barrel root washer and either roll it in, roll it out when we need it, where it's gonna best be used. And then in the space as you walk in, you'll be able to see that on the left-hand side is gonna be kind of our, as we bring in everything dirty, will be our vegetable wash packs zone. So we'll have two triple bay sinks, our kind of salad spinner station, at least two or three stainless steel packing tables, and then a couple tubs for like deep dipping of Swiss chard and kale and that sort of stuff, which we wholesale a lot of. And then we will have space for box storage and for our harvest. Our harvest bins will kind of remain outside in the dirty corner, and then the storage bins will be right inside, stored separately. And then as you, and then directly across from that on the other side of the barn will be the vegetable cooler. And then as you keep walking down, and there'll be a whole new slab put in and new LED lights and stuff, and then we're gonna insulate the whole space and insulate under the slab, and then we'll be able to actually heat the space, which will be a huge improvement for us because we've never had any sort of heated space for a crew to work in spring or fall when it's really kind of, you know, nasty and your fingers are freezing. We're gonna have hot water, which will be a huge improvement as well for both the flower health and for our hands. So that'll be a great improvement. So as you walk past the vegetable zone, then there's gonna be the flower pack and arranging area on the other, on that side as well. And across from that will be a flower cooler. And then next to that will be our office and crew space, which we will have never really had an official one of those, which would be great. And then we're gonna have this whole middle space in the bay of the barn, which will be kind of like a floating free space, but we'll be able to have workshops and classes in there, which is gonna be a really nice benefit because we've always kind of lacked that rain, you know, rain date space to really invite the public into our farm. So we'll be able to do a lot of flower arranging classes and workshops, which we've already scheduled, and have brides and their families come into the barn and do stuff as a group or on their own and picking up bulk stems and stuff like that. So really just gonna make the space a lot more versatile, as well as we're gonna add in a bathroom, which is amazing for many reasons. We'll have a bathroom on site, and then we'll also have, we're setting it up with the eye towards renting the space out for caterers and other small businesses. So we're gonna set up a separate kind of another three bay sink for caterers with a grease trap and tying it back to the septic, since we're doing the bathroom anyways, and just trying to keep an eye towards, you know, having the space be a moneymaker for our farm for year round. And then down the road when we're done farming, it should be a really marketable space for somebody else. If they're not gonna continue farming the property, at least it will be set up for another small business. So we're just trying to really think long term and hopefully help us pay back the investment that we're making in the space now a little bit quicker by being able to hopefully find some sort of relationship with another business that can really be compatible and really benefit both of our farm business and their business as well. So the main impetus for us kind of switching gears on this project, I was gonna keep kind of putting band-aids on the upstairs of the barn and making it continue to work. But when we really looked at this barn, it's such an asset that we already have on the farm, and it's such a huge amount of indoor space that instead of building more kind of outdoor sheds, we've decided to really kind of focus on the fact that there already was some sort of foundation here. It's a really solid barn. So we are gonna end up redoing the slab because we do wanna add insulation, but so you'll notice that on the backside of the barn, there's the remnants of silos. So we're first gonna get rid of those silos so that the pads will be gone and the metal frames will be gone, and that will give us much better flow and water drainage away from the barn, you know, helping maintain our barn health, and also just give us that awesome traffic flow that we've been really missing to kind of be able to skirt around and then go underneath our new pole barn. And then you'll see that currently it's a pretty dark, dank dairy barn that nobody really wants to hang out in downstairs. So we're really looking to bring light into the space for sure. Obviously heat is gonna be a huge factor, but we're gonna replace a bunch of the windows. I think we're adding probably 5 new larger windows on the south side of the building. So we'll have some nice sun in there. And then we're gonna have, because we're getting rid of this lab, we're gonna have a lot more headroom and a lot of the barn, which will be really nice. And then we'll add new flush LED lighting all on the top to also help with keeping that improved visibility on product quality and bridal flower quality. And then you'll also notice the we're kind of making it work with the poles in the barn. You'll see there's, you know, the old poles that still support the barn. We're kind of designing the space based on where those poles are. So our coolers will kind of be located to make work, you know, the things that are necessary to keep the barn in place as is.